Welcome back to Innocence Tarot. We're going to do another Divine Masculine update. We're going to use the Journey to Divine Masculine. Once I finish shuffling, I will turn down the music after I finish shuffling. Let's get into it. I'm a G5 nigga. The next city in the air. You make G fly with us. It's like Hope got big. It's like B got jigger. Really though, let me take y'all back. Oh, nah, never lie. Drop top, put the top down. Boy, just never work. I doubt you. I spit my game. It ain't work. I shot down. But I can tell by the fan, by the wrist and the ring on that. Somebody had it on lockdown. And more of the story, not to speak on that. She on the team, she'll be mine now. And we'll never, ever, ever make love. We'll never, ever, ever say love. Unless I'm all up in it. She telling me she love that D. I don't know how to say hell. Bad bitch, you ain't not made up. Anybody wanna buy? The heart from a real one from Philly, rubbing that no sack. Yo! Anybody wanna buy? Anybody wanna buy love? Push that like button and subscribe would be greatly appreciated, okay? Y'all, I went to my mama's house today, right? Because she made me some oxtail. Well, she made everybody some oxtail. She just told me to come over there and pick up a plate. So I go over there and I go and eat my oxtails and everything, you know what I mean? And like an hour later, right? My mom is on the phone with my granny and everything, and the doorbell ring, right? So it's the UPS man. So while my mama on the phone and everything, I tell her, because I hear the doorbell, I tell her, I'll get it, right? I'll open that door, and oh my God, you talk about a beautiful, beautiful looking man. You know when you just see a beautiful man, he just pretty. I know you ain't supposed to call a man pretty or beautiful, but he was beautiful, okay? He was beautiful. So as I'm signing, you know, you got to sign stuff before they give you your packages and shit, right? So I'm signing for my mom, writing her name and everything. So in the background, you know my mom on the phone with my granny. All of we hear is, I love nuts, okay? And then I hear my mama talking about, I love pecan nuts, pistachios, but it was just quiet. And all of a sudden, she's like, I love nuts. So while I'm signing, he look at me, I look at him. We just bust up laughing, me and the UPS man, right? So then I get to hear my mama get the name and all the nuts and everything. I'm like, I know she ain't talking like that. And the UPS man talking about she love me. too. Like, I love nuts. So when we look at each other. But she was talking about, you know, pecan nuts and pistachio nuts and everything. But the shit was so funny. Anyway, we both start laughing and everything, right? So he said, well, I'm going to go get the packages and everything. So he bring the packages back and everything, right? And he say, you know what? He said, you got good energy and everything. He's like, can I take you out sometime? He was like, can I get your number? I was like, well, you can give me your number because, you know, I've been taking applications. A lot of people been approaching me, but I ain't giving nobody my phone number because I'm the type of person, I like to be bothered when I feel like being bothered. You know what I mean? So I've just been taking applications and, you know, I'll take their phone number if I'm interested and I feel as though, you know, you're worthy of my time or whatever down the line. When I'm ready, I will call you because I don't like my phone going off and you know what I mean? All that type of unnecessary shit. You know what I mean? Only when I'm into a person like that. I don't like to do that pretty nilly, just giving my number out to people. Nah, I don't do that, right? So anyway, he sit up here. So I tell him, I say, well, no. He said, I never ever had nobody sit up here and say, I'll take your number and everything. I said, I know you don't, because you out here looking like a snack, right? So he started laughing again. But anyway. So I took his number. He writing his number down and everything. He get to telling me he's from New York, and that his baby mother, that was his high school sweetheart or whatever, she passed away like 2 years ago in a car accident, and that he came to California with his little 6-year-old son, okay, to be able, you know, to get help from his mother and everything. So then he said, well, can I show you some pictures? So he go to the truck while he bring me my pack. Well, bringing my mama her packages and shit. And he get to showing me the pictures of the little boy and everything, okay? And I'm like, okay, well, I'll take your number and everything, and I'll be in contact. But it might be a little while until I'm ready to reach out to you. But don't take no offense or anything. I'm still healing, and I just got out of a relationship, too. Guess what he said? He said, you want me to pray with you? I was like, okay. So, you know what I mean? But the point that I'm making is, you're going to meet all type of different people, okay? God going to let a lot of people cross your path, okay? For all type of different reasons, okay? To date, to just be friends, all type of shit, you know what I'm saying? But I just recommend you because, you know, I love you, girl, okay? We sisters. And you take their number, okay? Don't nobody want their phone just willy-nilly going off unless you got 2 or 3 phones. I got 2 phones, too, but I just don't like my phone ringing and stuff like that, okay? I like my peace these days, so when, you know what I mean? So I'll take your number. We taking applications. We ain't sitting up here and gave nobody, you know, that job is being our man yet, okay? When you become our man, you get that number. We got a right to take that application, you know what I mean? So I took his number, but you know what I mean? But what the point that I'm saying is, I was just going to get the packages, okay? Now, even though he looked like a snack, oh, he showed up at that door like heaven, okay? Like, ooh. I was like, wow. I was like, my, my, my. You know, like Johnny Gill got that song? My, my, my. But that was what was going on in my head, though. But anyway, the point that I'm making is that you're going to meet people in all type of different ways, okay? So who would have known my mama talking about, I love nuts. Would have sat up here and broke the ice. Well, you least expected it, okay? That's all I'm saying, okay? So, yeah. So, make sure you push that like button and subscribe. And we about to get into this reading, y'all. How's everybody doing, okay? I just wanted to share that with y'all, okay? But, yeah. I'm just letting you guys know because you know all these readings keep talking about Nunu is coming. We don't know who Nunu gonna be. But I'm just saying, you just gonna meet people when you least expecting it. I'm just saying, good people, real good people. You know what I mean? People that ain't on the bullshit. You know what I mean? But yeah, okay, I done talked to y'all enough. Y'all know y'all my angels, my little bouquets, my adorable queen. You know what I mean? So let's get into it. Yeah, so Divine Masculine, okay? He's been sitting up here overindulging, drinking, using drugs, trying to cope, okay, with what decisions that he made. Divine Masculine's conscience is really, really bothering him right now, okay? To the spirit guides, okay, have shown up to try to help Divine Divine Masculine, trying to help Divine Masculine guide him, okay? Divine Masculine is under judgment right now, and it's a lot of things that's happening to him that's becoming overwhelming, okay? For real. God is starting to turn more to God's spirituality, starting to build this relationship with God. You have no other choice when you're going through karma, okay? But Divine Masculine, he wants you to know that he's in full regret. Full regret for sitting up here ghosting you, doing you dirty, all because he wanted to fuck a bitch, okay? All because he wanted to travel and fuck a bitch, okay? And end up taking the coward's way out. Didn't give you no explanation, didn't say shit to you, up and ghosted you, and didn't say nothing, okay? And never ever made the shit right, okay? Divine Masculine took the coward's way out just to go fuck a bitch, okay? That's exactly what the fuck he did, okay? Up and ghosted you, okay? And full regret, okay? Because you was nothing but loyal to him, there for him. Divine Masculine, no, you didn't deserve that bullshit. Divine Masculine been trying to suppress his feelings. He been trying to run away from his conscience. But Divine Masculine can no longer sit up here and run from his conscience and what he did. It's really, really bothering him on what he did. And it's about time, okay, that it is. Because he walking around like he didn't give a fuck after hurting you, okay? Divine Masculine wants you to know that he's been extra detached because he's been trapped in a relationship, a situationship, in a commitment, okay? This is why he detached. This is why he haven't reached out, okay? Over here trying to keep his word to this karmic, but couldn't keep his word to you, okay? Divine Masculine wants you to know that he wasn't ready to surrender his bad ass actions. He wasn't ready to change. He wasn't ready to take that mask off. Divine Masculine wasn't ready to do and surrender, okay, to this twin flame journey. He wasn't ready to walk, okay, in the light. He wasn't ready, okay? He wasn't ready to change his deceptive ass behavior and ways, okay? And this is why he up and ghosted you, even though you was loyal, okay? Divine Masculine do finally feel remorse for what he has done, okay? Ever since Divine Masculine ghosted you, he been going through hardships. God has been attacking what he loves the most, money, okay? Not making it right with you, shitting on the Empress, okay? An earth angel out here doing right and being loyal, and this is the thanks that he did to you. God said, okay, I got something for your motherfucking ass. God said, I'm going to sit up here and attack them finances. I'm going to make sure that you ain't out here living easy breezy with another bitch after hurting my child, okay? God said, This is why Divine Masculine is very overloaded right now. A lot of different responsibilities. A lot of people is coming at him. A lot of bills is due. Divine Masculine is starting to see that he got to save himself. He's tired of being responsible for everybody else's bills. He's tired of doing and going through all this shit with everything on his back. Divine Masculine is finna have to be independent. Divine Masculine gonna have to walk away and let other people take care of their own bills, okay? Why he wanna be out here tricking, taking care of all these damn households and all these bitches and all these responsibilities to be able to fuck? God said, you finna be on your own. God just gonna give Divine Masculine enough to take care of himself. All that people-pleasing shit is over and done with, okay? Because God is really attacking his finances, okay? Divine Masculine ain't got it like he used to. Money is funny right now, okay? And this is what God is doing to get Divine Masculine's attention, okay? Divine Masculine has been soul-searching, thinking about how fucked up he was to take the coward's way out. How fucked up he was just to do you dirty, act like he didn't know you, mistreat you like he did when you was nothing but loyal to this man, okay? Divine Masculine wants you to know that it hurt for him to sit up here and separate away from you. But this karmic and his mama was up in his ear and his family and friends, and they didn't want him to have this new beginning with you. His mama and his karmic was on him, and his mama encouraged him to stay with this karmic and not take a leap of faith and start a brand new beginning with you. This is the reason why Divine Masculine end up sitting up here abandoning you. This is why Divine Masculine did you dirty and ghosted you. He ghosted you and did you dirty on abandoning you, okay? To sit up here and do what this karmic wanted his ass to do. And he had a one-night stand. He did all this when he ghosted you, okay? Had a one-night stand. And then end up going back to this karmic, okay, who his mama wanted him to be with, okay, and began to sit up here and work on their relationship. Divine Master say he was contemplating on what to do. He didn't know how to go about letting you know that he was going back to the karmic, that he wasn't starting no new beginning with you. This is why he took the coward's way out. This is why he didn't be a man. This is why he didn't walk in the right energy that day, okay? Had the nerve to ghost you because both of these musty mouth ass bitches just couldn't sit up here and mind their fucking business. They was hating on this masculine having a new beginning, okay? And Divine Masculine refused God's gift, and now look what Divine Masculine going through. He going through hardships. His stability is being affected, okay? Everything is on his fucking shoulders, okay? He made the wrongest decision in the fucking world when he walked away from you. That was one of his dumbest moves, and he is paying for it, okay? Tower after tower, bad luck after bad luck. So many different things is coming at him at one time because he did not take that new beginning with you, lied to you, disrespected you, and did have the nerve to ghost you, okay, and cheat on you, okay? This man did a lot of coward ass shit for no fucking reason when he separated away from you, okay? Left the relationship stagnant, okay? Because he wanted to be out here fucking multiple bitches, and he wanted to sit up here and do what his mama and his karmic wanted him to do. They get along, okay? Divine Masculine still doing what his mama tell his ass to do, okay? Just like he used to when he was a kid, not wanting to upset her. Really end up, the karmic is a lot like his mama. Messy shit starting, and always don't let him feel like a man. They take the power, okay? This is why the karmic and his mama get along. They both one in a nutshell, okay? And Divine Masculine is a mama's boy. Always wanting to please his mama, always wanting to sit up here and make her happy, even if he ain't happy with the decisions, okay? And he regrets it. Ever since he pulled ways away from you, he been trying to reach you telepathically, okay? Your Divine Masculine has been in solitude. Your Divine Masculine has been going in the bathroom to cry it out, to let it out so nobody see. He been really going through it. Divine Masculine is like really in his emotions, feeling real fucked up on how he sat up here and did you, Divine Feminine. You was nothing but loyal to this man. You was devoted to this man. You wanted to spend your life with this man. You genuinely liked him for him. You genuinely wanted to build a relationship with him, okay? And he did you dirty. And had the nerve to never talk to you, okay? Not reach out, not make things right, not give you an explanation, all type of shit. He did. And he's feeling like shit about it because you was nothing but good to him. You didn't deserve none of this shit, Divine Feminine, okay? And he feels like shit about what he did, okay? In full regret, Divine Feminine, okay? He is, okay? He wants you to know, okay, that don't nobody make him feel the way that you made him feel. When he was with you, he felt as though he could take on the world. He felt like a man. He felt like a king. He felt like all things was possible with you in Christ Jesus, okay? Divine Masculine missed those days when you would speak life into him, when you was able to know how to get him back in order. See, your divine masculine suffers from depression. He suffers from a lot of trauma he done been through. And then he's a people pleaser. And then all he wants to be is loved and liked. And he goes about it the wrong way, okay? But when he was with you, when he had those down days, when he had them days that he didn't feel like shit, them days when he was going up against shit, you was the person that was building him up, giving him that strength, giving him that warrior energy, okay? He see it, okay? He see it and he feels the difference without you in his life, okay? Divine Masculine got the clarity. Got the clarity, okay, that you is the one that complete him. Got the clarity that their heart beat for you, okay? He can fuck this one, he can fuck that one, okay? Don't nobody make him feel the way you make him feel, okay? He knows that he's in love with you. He got the clarity on that, okay? And he said he got the clarity, okay? Okay, let me tell it, basically. He said he got the clarity, he got the knowledge, and he know what complete him. Okay, if you didn't know, he letting you know. He got the clarity. He know you his baby. Oh, he know now. Oh, he know. He got the knowledge of it, and it hurts so bad. Oh, it hurts so bad, okay, now that he get it. And he feels as though it's too late. Divine Masculine is seeing all the signs, okay, that you was the one all along, Divine Feminine. He got the clarity all along. It was you, Divine Feminine, okay? You was the missing piece. You was the missing ingredient. You is the one that make the soup taste good, okay? You, okay? And Divine Masculine is planning on trying to set up, planning on reaching out to communicate with you, but just don't know how, okay? Ain't been no contact in so long, okay, he don't know what to say, what to do, but what he is doing is he's trying to sit up here and figure out how, when he wants to sit up here and communicate with you. Divine Masculine has been in his ego. He wished that he wasn't in his ego, okay, back then, and then communicate, then say something to you, okay? He know that that's what put the daggers in your heart, okay? Him not reaching out, him not saying nothing, okay? You felt some type of way about that shit, okay? It's one thing a motherfucker want to go cheat. It's another thing you want to go change up and be with the next bitch, okay? But this motherfucker didn't even communicate, text, or say shit. That's how much he thought about you, okay? That's what you have an issue with. And he had the nerve to be in his ego when he was out here entertaining the next bitch, trying to sit up here and make her feel comfortable, okay? This is why his ass over there doing all these fucking drugs and shit, because he know that he was dead wrong. And he keep on doing these fucking narcotics and drinking and shit, he gonna be dead. He need to chill, okay? That's what he need to do, okay? Been up here trying to suppress his feelings all this fucking time. Now the light bulb that came on, okay, that he really in love with you. Now he see, okay, the truth, okay? Then now and then want to sit up here and work with you as a team, but know that he unworthy to have you. He know that he don't deserve you. Divine Feminine, you is an angel and you're very rare, okay? You out here keeping your legs closed, you out here doing big things, okay? What make you, you can't find nowhere else, okay? And he know he don't deserve you. You a rare breed, okay? Straight up, okay? And now he want to work with you now that everything else is going left, okay? Now that all this chaos and bullshit is going on, okay? For real. Now his ass is ready to sit up here and compromise with you now. Want to sit up here and do what he's supposed to do on this twin flame journey, praying for God to bring you back into his life and everything. Now he want to sit up here and compromise, praying, hoping that he was worthy, okay? When he know damn well that he unworthy to have your love, okay? He can pray all day, okay? His actions don't make it to the point that he is worthy, okay? Divine Masculine going through a whole lot of chaos, a whole lot of drama right now, okay? And let's not forget, he going through a spiritual awakening. He going through a spiritual awakening, because you know when you're going through your spiritual awakening, you know all kind of chaos. God get to removing people out your life. God get to creating them tower moments, okay? God get to setting you up right, okay? And this is what the masculine is going through. Him, he's already affecting his finances on what divine masculine care about the most, okay? Divine masculine has been sitting up here listening to a whole lot of music. Divine masculine, okay, was in denial about this family setup, okay? But he realizes that he loves the kids, but he don't love the situation. And and what makes that family, okay? He's not happy within his family dynamic, and he's tired of denying and pretending like he is, okay? Divine masculine want to sit up here and work as a team with you, but the reason he ain't came back to work with a team as you, because he don't want to go against his family. He don't want to piss his mother off, okay? Let me push this over, okay? Divine masculine, okay, has been beating himself up, okay? Talking shit to himself in the mirror on how he did you, okay? He should, because he lost a good woman. Oh, he lost a good woman, okay? And when Nunu gets you, he ain't letting go, okay? They got a song back in the day that's called the old, just talking about toast to the food that let you go, okay? That's what Nunu gonna be saying to Divine Masculine, like, you let her go? Like, what? You let a priceless lottery ticket go? Do you know who you dealing with? Because Nunu gonna know. Nunu gonna know right up front exactly who you is. That Empress energy is just glowing, okay? Magnetizing, okay? And Divine Masculine gonna be in that mirror each and every day cussing his own self out like, you dumb motherfucker. You know you done fucked up, right? That's what he gonna be telling himself. All because he wanted to stay in his fucking pride. And he wanted to sit up here and let his mama run his life while he over there miserable with a musty mouth ass bitch, okay? Living in a family dynamic that he ain't even happy in, okay? For real. Divine Masculine is used to people popping off and talking shit to him, okay? This is what his mama did to him all his life. Made him feel like shit. Made him feel like he had to buy people and do this and do that because whoever... whoever his mom is was always talking shit, and this masculine felt like he could never do right, okay? And when he finally did do right or do what his mom wanted him to do, that was the only time that she would be nice to him. So he grew up sitting up here feeling like, if I just do what she tell me to do, my mom is going to love me. She going to like me, okay? But all along, his mama's a selfish-ass bitch, just like the karmic. That's how she is. Shit-talking, wanting her way, power-hungry, and won't finances, okay? And feels as though she needs to run this man's life because she lonely, because she bitter, and because nobody wants to deal with her. And she going to set up her son to keep going through this shit that ain't nobody going to want to deal with him on him trying to please this woman, okay? For real. See, Divine Masculine got low self-esteem. He got low self-esteem, and his mama knows it, and she uses that shit to her advantage to run his life, okay? He taking care of her household and everybody else's, and instead of her doing, letting him be happy on who he's going to be with, okay? Divine Masculine want to sit up here and ask you for your forgiveness, okay? Divine Masculine is in lack mentality energy right now because his money is funny, okay? Divine Masculine is still at a crossroads if he's ready to sit up here and keep it real. Is he ready to confess, okay, and tell you the truth? But you already know the truth. You just waiting for him to confirm it. You want to see if he gonna give you that gift on telling the fucking truth, okay? That's what you want, okay? He can't stop thinking about you. He's seeing all type of signs and synchronicities, okay? With the Divine Masculine wants the opportunity. He wants the opportunity in order for you to roll the dice and take another chance and let him back into your life. Divine Masculine is ready to work as a team, okay? Because he see how lovable you really are. So, yeah, we're going to leave it there, and I will be back with another reading. I love each and every one of you guys. Make sure you subscribe, and I'll be back. Bye.